by virtue of the power and authority vested in me by the state of California, I now declare you spouses for life.
Gay marriages resume in California with some of the plaintiffs from Prop 8 just 2 days after the U.S. Supreme Court cleared the way. Good evening, everyone. I'm Dan Green. Aaron Clark is off tonight. We are beginning with the federal court stay on same-sex marriage. It was lifted late this afternoon, meaning ceremonies could resume immediately, and statewide couples have already tied the knot. Locally, county clerks say they've got the weekend to prepare. They're expecting a busy day on Monday. Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen has more tonight live from our Salinas News.
Well, Dan, in some areas of the state, couples were married within minutes of this stay being lifted. Here locally, county clerks will be issuing licenses and performing a lot of weddings come Monday.
I'm completely ecstatic that any relationship I choose will now be legalized.
The district court decision sinking in hours after it became reality.
This is a really momentous, huge, big deal.
After years of waiting, California couples can marry. Employees at the Santa Cruz County Clerk's Office called a list of 18 couples to let them know.
We're starting to issue marriage licenses. We wanted to get an appointment for you.
Preparing for Monday, when the office will offer appointments for marriage licenses and weddings performed every half hour.
I have 3 venues, so I can run 3 ceremonies at the same time.
From 9 in the morning until 8 Monday night, there are openings for 70 ceremonies. 6 are confirmed so far.
I will be checking phone messages at our office all weekend long and returning calls and setting up appointments.
In San Francisco, just minutes after the court stay was lifted, people were lining up to get marriage licenses and then saying, "I do." Attorney General Kamala Harris officiated the ceremony for Chris Perry and Sandy Steer, two of the plaintiffs challenging Prop 8.
I now declare you spouses for life.
It's extraordinary. It's extraordinary. We're all living in a moment in history.
2 more plaintiffs in the Prop 8 case married, Paul Katami and Jeff Zarrillo's wedding, presided over by LA's mayor.
The opportunity to right a wrong was there.
And for the LGBT community, it means looking forward to forever.
It's a really big relief. I'm able to have the choice to marry a man. And in my future, I know that I want children in my life. So it really means a lot to me that I get to have this choice of this marriage.
I don't have to be scared that if I get married to a woman, that it won't be recognized and that my spouse will never have the same privileges.
Winning that in California and being able to celebrate that here locally and throughout the nation, it just brings everybody, even people who don't care about LGBT issues, it brings everybody closer together.
Well, 6 couples have made appointments to get their licenses in Santa Cruz County so far. 4 of those will be getting married at the Santa Cruz County Courthouse. Now, no one today made it into the office to get their licenses before 5 o'clock. But as far as other areas here locally, Dan, Monterey County says nothing will happen before Monday. And in San Benito County, the registrar's office closed at 1 o'clock this afternoon. So nothing coming out of there today.
All right. Very good. Thank you very much. Appreciate it, Brittany. Now, while there is room for 70 weddings on Monday in Santa Cruz, 6 have already been scheduled. To give you an idea what the turnout could be, about 20 weddings are conducted on a typical Valentine's Day. And when gay marriages were allowed in June of 2008, more than 60 couples were married in Santa Cruz.